A New York-based Filipino priest sees many reasons for the rise in anti-Asian hate crimes, among them the lack of response from the community and the lax enforcement of anti-discrimination laws. Father Julian Hagudilia, director of the Migrant Center of New York, also highlights the role played by former President Donald Trump in fueling anti-Asian hate with his inflammatory rhetoric on the origins of COVID-19. Hagudilia adds Filipino victims of such attacks may be hesitant to file complaints, believing it could affect their immigration status.
Ang iba din, mga biktima ng mga Filipino, ayaw nilang mag-report dahil ang iba sa kanila, mga walang papel. So, working with the NYPD, working with the Commission on Human Rights and Immigrants Affair of New York City, and of course with the state, we assured them that, you know, kapag nag-report sila, ang kanilang immigration status will not be revealed.
An overseas Filipino worker in New York, meanwhile, urges caution for those planning to visit the city, admitting that she no longer feels safe herself.
Until now, natatakot pa din akong sumakay ng train.
Mm-hmm.
Pati especially when I go to Manhattan, natatakot ako kasi lingon pa din ako ng lingon sa likod ko, baka may biglang mag-assault sa akin sa likuran ko. So that's why right now, I'm not carrying a pepper spray.
Your protection should come from, you know, different sides. From the side of the government, from the side of the Philippine consulate, and from our sides, you know, sa atin din. Now we have to protect ourselves. So,
President Marcos's first State of the Nation address set to take place next week. Sherian Torres tells us what's on the so-called wish list of lawmakers or what they would want to hear from the chief executive, Sona.
The interiors of Batasan Complex is already spick and span, ready to welcome President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. for his very first State of the Nation address on Monday. Visitors expected to reach more than 1,300 will be required to present a negative RT-PCR test result, vaccination card, and invitation. Security in the area is now on a semi-lockdown status.
Konting mga adjustments na lang tayo, pero 100% okay na tayo sa for Monday next week sa zona ni President BBM. Limited na yung magiging access muna ng mga papasok sa house. The same time yung pasok ng mga only essential personnel lang muna ang papapasukin natin sa house. And total lockdown will be either Thursday or Friday.
Lawmakers we've talked to have already prepared a list of what they hope to hear from the president. Among them, neophyte Senator Robin Padilla, who is admittedly excited to join the occasion.
Hindi pa ako na-experience nung nandun ka na, di ba? Yung hindi ka third person eh. Ito, ngayon, talagang wow. Excited ako. Ano bang sasabihin niya tungkol sa drug war? Ano bang sasabihin niya tungkol sa build? Yung tungkol sa agriculture. Kasi ito dito kami nagkakatugma ni PBBM nung sinabi sa plataforma na dapat buhayin natin ang agriculture. Gusto kong madinig lahat yun.
Senator Joel Villanueva is hoping to hear Marcos Jr.'s plan for workers as well as his foreign policy that affects the migrant workers' interests. But for Senator Nancy Binay, it's better to hear what the chief executive's whole plan for the nation.
Ano ba yung nakikita niyang plano kung paano tayo makakaahon dahil sa epekto ng pandemic, dahil sa epekto ng pagtaas ng presyo ng gasolina. So maganda yung kumbaga ano yung magiging roadmap for the next 6 years. I think yun yung dapat mailatag na niya during his first SONA.
A true address, according to Senator Francis Escudero, should be frank and candid. Escudero is also looking forward to hearing Marcos Jr.'s narration of the current state of the nation, his plans, and legislative agenda. Senator Aquilino Coco Pimentel, meantime, wants the president to state if the Duterte administration really spent much, leaving the Marcos government cash strapped. Pimentel also wants to know how much do we owe today and how do we intend to repay this. For Senator Risa Ontiveros, the SONA should provide a detailed program in combating the looming food crisis.
Sasabihin nila sa atin yung totoong estado ng ating bansa at higit doon ay maglalatag sila ng mga hakbang para tugunan ang sitwasyong ito. Unang-una na yung food crisis para hindi maging food catastrophe. Yung solusyon sa presyo ng diesel at dahil doon sa lahat pa ng mga bilihin, kasama na rin ang pagkain.
Still, Marcos Jr.'s ally, Senator Jingo Estrada, is looking forward to a more unifying statement from the president.
I expect our president, Bongbong Marcos, to contain his priority measures on how to realize his campaign promise of Bangon Bayan Muli, or Bayan Bangon Muli, which can guide us legislators as to what measures to prioritize and consider with urgency.
But for Senator Juan Miguel Zubiri, infrastructure issues should not be left behind.
Marami din po sa atin ay excited sa build plans ng ating Pangulo, particularly on infrastructure development. So ano po yung mga ibabanggit niya, mga priorities, particularly sa build program?
Still, members of the Makabayan Bloc say a solid SONA should include specified programs and not just another call for national unity.
Walang solusyon ang gobyerno at hindi natin yun maririnig sa SONA, abay dapat mag-isip-isip yung ating mga mamamayan kaugnay sa pamamahala o paggo-gobyerno sa ating bayan.
Cagayan de Oro Congressman Rufus Rodriguez meantime reminded the president not to leave Mindanao behind in terms of budget allocation. The president's cousin, late Congressman Martin Romualdez, for his part, gives this assurance.
I know he has some many plans in store for us. I believe he will guide us, no, with the legislative agenda, and it will obviously revolve around the most important piece of legislation, the budget, maybe not just only of 2023, but moving forward for the ensuing years, based on the economic conditions and the exigencies and the priorities of the admin.
Around 22,000 policemen will be deployed to ensure order during the occasion, says National Police Officer in Charge, Lieutenant General Vicente Dano Jr. Commonwealth Avenue area, which served as the main venue of ralliers the past years, has been declared a no-rally zone. And because Monday is SONA Day, there will be traffic rerouting in areas near the Batasan Complex in Quezon City. Details can be accessed at the MMDA website. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.